Over this way, over this way.
Oh, Mr. Thorne, this is an extremely dangerous spot. Right here.
Get over there.
Division Super 2, and he was about your size.
Well, you must think you're as tough as I am.
Well, if you and me is blowing enough smoke for now, I'll be on my way.
Now, some people would let you do just that. Me, I'm going to give you a chance to put some of them guns into a job.
Work on a railroad again? No chance. The rent's against you, Super.
On this road and for me. I'm Dan Thorne, and what I say goes around here. That means everybody, see?
Yeah. Everybody but me.
Joe. I'd like to have a new man for your cellar packer job.
You know engine?
Sure, used to work on the Lake Division. Go ahead and meet Joe Gurry, the roundhouse foreman.
Oh, glad to know you. Dan says you're all right. It's okay with me. Get busy on the big boy here. It's next out.
Hey, ah, boy, there's your job.
Yeah. So you think I'm working, huh?
If them jail boxes ain't greased in half an hour, it'll burn the heart out of you, big fella.
Sure. But I ain't working, understand? I ain't working. That's a fine way to leave an engine.
You wouldn't think I'd be late with you waiting for me, Mary, would you?
Hey, I'm going to enter a complaint. Somebody's getting a lot of attention around here besides me.
Oh, sure, go on with you. You wouldn't be jealous of your own father, would you?
Wouldn't I?
Say, I'm likely to be jealous of anybody.
What's that?
Oh, yes. Say, Mary, I want you to do something for me. I want you to go down the roundhouse. I got a new man down there. He's a floater, and his name is Doyle. Give him this bundle and this note and see what he does, huh?
Now, Dan, I wish you wouldn't bother your head about those tramps. You know, it never turns out right.
Mary, a fella can go wrong a dozen times, but if you're right once, it makes up for all the rest. Will you do it?
Well, all right.
Well, I got here just in time, didn't I?
You did that.
Hey! Ain't you afraid you're gonna get those clothes dirty? Nah, I guess my pal had something to do. You ought to try and wear overalls once in a while. You guys must be particular about getting your pants dirty. I see you didn't notice them loose driving rod nuts. What, those nuts loose again? Oh, that's all right. I fixed them myself. She's all ready to roll.
Thanks.
Come in. Read this.
I didn't ought to take this from you.
No, no.
I want to be moving on. I don't think I'll ever be happy around here.
What do you mean,
happy?
You're going to stick here because I tell you, see?
I guess you know what I want to say.
Oh, well, don't say it.
Hello, hello, Dan. Say, this is Chuck. Say, old Tom Johnson's wife died this morning. Yeah. He's on the loose. He's in that joint down by the lower yards. I did what I could, but after she passed away, I couldn't hold him. Okay, Dan. I'll keep it to myself.
Mary, I'm sorry. I've got to believe you. I've got a tough call, and
Dan,
I've got to
Dan, you'll be back in time for the party tonight, won't you?
Party? What party?
The old-timers' picnic.
By golly, I forgot all about it. But I can't go anyway, Mary.
Oh, you have to go, Dan.
No, I can't. This is very important. I got it. You can go with Larry.
No. No, I want to go with you.
No, 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 no. Now, listen, Mary. This is very, very... Now, I haven't got much more time to dress. You better... And say, Larry, there you are. You can be celebrating your new rating and help me out at the same time, huh? And I'll try to drop in later. Huh? That's fine, that's fine. Well, so long. So long.
I guess that settles it.
I guess it does.
Do you want to go with me?
Yes.
Ladies and gentlemen, your attention please to the next feature on the program. That mighty spectacle presented by our own boys and on our own engine. A tug of war between two colossal moguls of the run.
Feel the same way.
I see Wall Street has dropped again today.
Scram.
The hospitality of this place is absolutely appalling.
Nobody else can stop me, huh? I'm gonna drink tonight.
I ain't here to stop you. How do you get that way?
Hey, give me a shot of that stuff, will you? Well, here's to you, Tom.
You can't do that.
Why can't I? I guess a couple of old friends can have a drink together, huh?
Yeah, but you're the boss of this here division.
Young Larry Doyle's whistle, wasn't it?
Yes. He's taking the general manager's car and the dynamometer back to the yards.
He hasn't been around here much since the old-timers' party.
No.
Dan Thorne's worked wonders in that boy, Mary.
Well, I think Larry deserves a little credit himself.
No. No. Dan Thorne was responsible. Dan Thorne, Mary. He's a great man.
I know. You needn't worry, Dad. I'm going to marry him.
Just a minute, Professor. And how, may I ask, did you find your way onto this train?
Mr. Thorne, I've been patronizing your road for a good many years, and I cannot understand why I should be jiggled around this railroad yard for 3 or 4 days. It's absolutely imperative that I arrive at Chicago before the 19th. Everything depends on it. Why can't you furnish me with adequate transportation to take me to my destination?
Professor, the entire road is at your service. See that train down there?
Yeah.
That train goes straight through to Chicago.
Sir?
With my compliments.
Thank you. I shall recommend this road to all of my friends.
Thank you.
Don't you think it hurts me? He's taken care of us.
That's no use, Murray. It's operated from the tower.
It's no use.
This thing's like a vice.
And I'm only going to get what I deserve, I guess.
Oh, no, no, Larry, no.
Now, Murray, get off the track.
No, I won't leave you.
Oh, please, Mary, get away.
No, I won't
leave you. Can't stay here, Mary.
No,
please,
won't.
Go on away.
No,
get off the track, please.
I won't.
I'm going to kill you. I'm going to kill you.
Dad, it's from part of the switch.
Go ahead, Dan. It's all right. I got it coming to me.
No, no, Dan. Don't. No, don't.
Party's at Market City. All right. Yeah. Hey, give me that. Give me that. Oh.
is the last time you'll ever ride this road.
If it's any news to you, it's the last time I'll ever ride any road.
Ah, come on.
Sure, it was his own wish that he'd come back here and die in his own division. That's a funny remark for Dan Thorne to make. I can't believe he...
And he used to be a nice fella, too.
Come on, get the lead out of your feet, or I'll come out there and knock that canyon for a row of gondolas. This ain't no smoking room, there's a railroad.